Ahead for Leach, knocked away by Renberg, moving up, a two-on-one with LeClaire. Renberg to the slot, Lindros, score!
My goodness, what a play again by Lindros. They win the puck between the blue lines, head up ice, three-on-one, and Lindros with that sneaky, quick release of the shot. His hands have to be so strong to do what he does, it's almost frightening. Rangers on the puck. It's chipped away right there by Gary Galley. And here go the Flyers. 3-on-2. Lindros, the hands on the stick. They don't move. Snap. In the goal. Almost off the goalpost again. 4-2 Flyers. Lindros has two. Look at that play. So quick. He took the pass in his skate blade, put it on his stick blade, and bang, it was in the goal.
For Lindros, one assist, one goal for LeClaire, one assist for Renberg. Over the span of 25 games that they've been playing together, they now have 116 points.
It's a misses stick. Eric has it, tries to protect. They rotate out of that corner. With it is Renberg, shot right into the breadbasket. Flyers are knocked down, they can't get the puck. Oh, side of the net, Lindros!
The line comes through. They continue the streak of scoring at least one goal in every game. Number 88 gets the go-ahead goal as the gloves touch by the bench. But that was just strong, aggressive, forechecking and hounding that puck. Look at John LeClaire colliding with Carey to knock him off balance. And Lindros gets it as he's being knocked over by Côté. But Gene, this line can bring it to another level when they want to. And when they look like they're playing well, they can just go dig a little deeper. Time and time again, when they really need a goal, the Flyers, they come through for you.
Number 23. Out to the far boards, 4 seconds on this. It'll be the last shot of the power play. Score! Timing.
Oh, did he whistle that one? Excellent shot by Eric Desjardins. He doesn't take that stick back very far, and a very concerned look on the face of head coach Roger Nielsen as he sees his team fall behind by 3 goals. Was that a power play goal, Gene?
Came right at the expiration of the Mellenby double minor.
There's the shot by Desjardins. High rising shot. Didn't look like it was screened from that angle. Let's see if we can pick it up again here. I don't think so.
The big guy get another point on that?
I'm gonna wait for the call this time. Good feed by Rob DeMaio.
We've had a scoring change, Gary, as you thought on that Flyers' third goal.
Well, Eric Lindros gets the goal. So that gives him 3 points. He was standing in front of the net along with Smith, and his stick deflected the puck high into the corner. So Lindros, with his 24th of the year, ties him with Michael Rowe.
Went wide. Desjardins in front. Oh, right there. There's Svoboda. Lost the shot to Desjardins. Rink wide. Score! Oh, my!
Was that set up beautifully or what? I'm telling you, that flip bottle, that one. That was beautiful to watch. And Eric Lindros, again, a point. 10 consecutive games, that matches his career best, or the year best. But what a one-timer, and Salo never had any chance on it. Couldn't get back in time. But Desjardins looked like he was going to shoot. I think he had everybody fooled. And Lindros, who is one of the best at the one-timer, made no mistake. And that nifty little through-the-legs pass by Svoboda. We had a lot in that.
The Bell Atlantic Yellow Pages proud to donate. Lost the edge. The big line is out there. They got Lindros in front. Backhand score! That time he didn't miss.
Now you keep getting those scoring chances, and sooner or later it's going to connect. So Renberg and Lindros extend their point streak to 11-gamer. Yes, there are Flyer fans here. They're scattered all over the building. They're probably making more noise than the Jersey fans.
They're excited about this hockey club. Number 26 for Lindros. But what a play by Michael Renberg. He stops on the dime, and as he's going down, flips the puck to Lindros, and in it goes. So John LeClair, Lindros, and Renberg get the Flyers' third goal.
How's that for a backbreaker, Gary? You get the first nine shots of the period at home. You have three power plays. You have a two-man advantage for a minute and 40 seconds. You get nothing, and the other team scores on its first shot after eight minutes right. And two.
Seen a lot of strange things over the years, have you, Gene?
Lindros, Renberg, met. Boy, look at LeClair going in. He's got to fight off the hold from behind by Neil Broughton. Flyers try to get it in front. There is Brodeur. It's in! They score! And you're looking at the Atlantic Division champions, my friends. Overtime on April the 22nd, 1995, the Flyers became the Atlantic Division champions for the first time in their history and have won nine in a row for the first time in 10 years. There goes the winner, Dominic Roussel. We'll just have to wait for the official. They got it behind the net. The big line was out there. Brodeur was on the seat of his pants, and it went in. That's LeClair. It's Renberg right there at the side of the net. Watch. He takes a whack at it and stops it short side. So Renberg from LeClair. How fitting. As Renberg picked up his 26th goal of the year, as did Lindros in the second period.
Devils none, game total 21.
Watch Renberg. I don't know how he got it, and did a little poke, as Brodeur obviously hadn't hugged the short side post, and he did a little bank shot into the net. Oh my! So the Flyers win it by the count of 4-3. And there is the celebration, and how fitting that the title should be clinched with the Legion on the ice. We'll be back to take in some of the celebration and the Flyers dressing room after we pause for these messages.
Defenseman, how does that feel?
That's why I don't play anymore. And Smelik is not a small player. He's got good size, but no one is bigger than Eric Lindros. I don't think anyone in the league hits harder than Eric Lindros.
Power play, Philadelphia. They're fifth in the NHL. On LeClair, leaves it for Renberg. The back pass to Desjardins for the shot. Score! Lindros may have tipped it in. Lindros gets the goal to tie it. The hard work along the boards again by Lindros, LeClair, and Renberg leads to a Flyers goal.
And Renberg with his great strength, it's just, you just can't knock him off the puck, and it ends up in the Buffalo goal after the tip. On the play, great work in the corner. Now Lindros is coming all the way from the corner. Desjardins sees him. Lindros coming here. The puck will come right there, and Lindros will tip it in. Outstanding play. Desjardins with his head up. He sees Lindros coming in all the way and puts it right on his stick. Lindros going to the net, and Hasek doesn't have a chance. How do you stop this guy in front of the net? You can't.
He does it all. Eric Lindros now has goals in four straight games and a 12-game point scoring streak.
Just when you think Buffalo was doing a good job defensively, they end up knocking the puck free. Renberg has it, is able to get it back to Desjardins, and all you have to do is get it to the net where the big players are.
Eric Lindros,
a good job in this game today.
Lindros has a goal, LeClair has a goal, Sweeney had his helmet knocked off, there's a penalty upcoming, and we've got more going on as Schmelik went after Lindros.
finally gets into the action. And here we go.
Smelik shouldn't have done that.
Smelik. He's overmatched here.
Oh, totally overmatched.
He's throwing a couple. He's trying to hang in there.
He's trying hard.
Smelik has been taking a lot of hits from Lindros, and when the whistle blew, he went at him.
Well, Smelik is strong, but he just can't stay with Lindros, the best conditioned athlete on the team. And he finally gets some help.
With a minute 8 remaining in the second period, that's a relief for Buffalo. They won't see Lindros for the next 5 minutes of play.
I was going to say, personally, it was a huge mistake. From the team standpoint, he does a good thing. The initial hit is John LeClair on Sweeney. That happened over on the other side of the ice. Sweeney didn't like that and went after LeClair. And then the other side is when Lindros and Smelik went at it. Lindros was trying to get away, finally said, that's enough. I'm not going to take this anymore. Hit him with one, finally dropped his gloves. And that's where Smelik thought, I shouldn't have done this. I'm in big trouble. He's yelling right now for the linesman.
Now the discussion.
Now the Flyers out. There's a pass into the slot. But everything just to shade off. Now Lindros scores!
Now that'll give the people something to cheer about. And again, the Lindros, Renberg, LeClair outfit with their size and strength just dominate when they get control of the puck. There's not much joy in the face of Lindros, though, with a team two behind. I just watched the cycling of the puck with Lindros moving over and just one-timing it, and Beaupre had absolutely no chance on it. Lindros is actually the forgotten man as he gets himself into a position and wraps it right off the right-hand goalpost as we see it.
Lindros, number 28.
And he scored in four consecutive games now, Gene.
Yeah, he's been on a run.
Goal scored by number 88, Eric Lindros.
Well, Renberg is going to get an assist, so he will.
Sold out crowd at the Coors State Spectrum.
Hey, did you hear about the new club box seats? I mean the special premium seats, the new Coors State Center?
Still no score as the big line comes out. They're quickly on the attack. Redbird to Leclerc, to Lindros, score! The big line does it again.
Do you think club box seats are good for client entertaining? With VIP parking, private bar, private restrooms, coat closets, definitely.
Club box seats are selling fast, so you better act fast. Call now at 389-9500.
The Flyer defense shoveled up nicely. Oh, they got a 2-on-1. Brindamore's going to take the shot. Pass, open net, score! Lindros!
What a marvelous play by Rod Brindamore, who's having a banner first period. Scored the first two goals and set up Eric Lindros to get his consecutive point streak to 14 games, plus scoring goals in six straight games. Boy, watch that quickness of Brindamore. He waited and waited till the defenseman made his move and then slid the puck over to Lindros. He just dumped it in the empty net. What a heads-up play by Rod Brindamore. Pronger, if he would have just stayed up on his skates, he might have been able to intercept that. And Gene, the Flyers scoring a goal in the last minute of the first period. You never want to do that.